he doing?
Cary Grant's here. It's fucking Cary Grant.
What is
Cary Grant.
What are you doing?
Hi, boy.
It's Cary Grant.
You're looking...
It started to rain. I just had my hair put on.
You're looking dapper.
You're looking...
How are you doing, Jay Morris?
Feeling dapper, Jethro.
You've been good.
You're looking Hollywood there.
You
sir.
Did look very Hollywood, walking down the hallway with your sunglasses. It looks like your scarf is looks like an ascot. And you got a nice jacket on.
You look like...
Well,
the...
it's wintertime, and I'm wearing a... Kentucky Fried Chicken t-shirt.
Oh, okay. Well,
I don't know how
that
Hollywood
kinda,
it looks. It's
that
the shades.
Kinda screwed it
it's
up.
The shades. The shades indoors and using my visitor's pass as a little handkerchief.
And the scarf helps, too. That
you
got
you never know
good.
When the media will be around, Anthony. Especially when you're a big shot on Broadway.
I was listening to the Jay Moore doing Colin Quinn in Reservoir Dogs bit from years ago.
We played it yesterday.
I know. I heard that. That's when I heard it. I was listening to
the goddamn word, stupid.
It was so fucking funny, man.
Doesn't Mo Margaret off. He looked just like Jeffrey Ross.
Yeah. Yes.
Did you?
That's been brought up a few times.
Okay. You guys have bandied that around
a little bit.
Yeah,
a few
people have.
You look like you have a neck. Brace.
I have a stiff neck, and it's
what happened.
I don't know. I just slept funny.
You slept funny. How else could Jay Moore sleep but funny?
I just woke up and I couldn't move my head at all.
Really?
Yesterday, and then I got a massage. I didn't do the acupuncture yet. I'm gonna go today. Big audition today.
Really?
Audition? You're already in the middle of something.
Oh, I know, but you gotta squeeze it all in, Ope. Nice. I used to have so much heat.
Heat? You're playing Charlie Sheen.
You know how
you got heat
Dice
right
wears blacks that don't match? I figured today I would wear whites that don't match.
Well, you're pulling
I figured
off.
I'd be the bright white knight of all that is good and tender. And
the Kentucky
luscious.
Fried shirt, the beige jacket thing.
Yeah, I didn't,
it's looking good.
I didn't
like
know
it.
What he was doing
I'm
when
still
he was
Sandinista, by the
I
way.
I saw the photo of you and Brock Lesnar, by the way. Holy smokes.
Oh, God.
You look like a Make-A-Wish kid, and you wanted him to sign your mitt.
Believe me. He squeezed down on my neck for a second, and my eyes just bulged
out. At least
out of my
Anthony
head.
Was brave enough to tweet the picture. I didn't even tweet mine. I'm like, I'm not doing
hysterical.
It. I'm not doing it to myself. Look at this.
I'm like, the second he did that, I went, what are you doing?
You look like you have progeria.
After that, I could have.
That's a real life monster, though.
Brain damage.
Yeah,
He's an action hero.
Extremely cool guy. Really cool guy. He's got a sense of humor. Likes to laugh.
They are those guys, right?
I didn't realize he was cool. I didn't realize.
How
at
was
all.
That? The sports
Norm?
Show with Norm. Yeah. I don't know. You know. For some reason, in all the still photos, my head is larger than everyone, though. look how large my head is compared to Anthony's there, you know? And it's, I come from a long line of death. My father died, my grandfather died, and I'm pretty sure his father died. I haven't met him or anything, you know?
That's so right on the money.
There we go. He fought a brave, brave battle with bowel cancer. It's not really that brave. Or a battle, for that matter, when you visit the person and they're laying in a bed with needles and tubes watching Matlock. That's not really a battle. They're not going, like punching their own body. And then they say, he lost his brave battle, his brave, brave battle with cancer. Well, if you die, the cancer dies. So that's sort of a draw. he didn't really lose. So why pile on the guy? He's dead already, you know? Yeah, he's already gone. At least give him the draw.
Holy
fuck, shit, is that
perfect. That is right on the fucking money. God damn, yeah, Jay.
Thank you.
Jay Moore.
You know what? I apologize for hitting your bell.
No, that's okay.
But he can't move his neck.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He walked down the hall. I'm like, I think he's going to play a character today. I thought you were going to play a character. I thought you were a separate character.
No, I can't move my head.
I know. Yeah.
Maybe so Cheryl Burke.
How are you going to do an audition?
Can walk on my neck.
Move your head.
With their little, fat potato feet. Colin, don't say that. She's coming in. What the hell do I care? With a giant labia flopping around the dance floor. I have a gig tonight in Long Island City, Queens. I booked it before I got all this heat.
Yeah, we do.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We got Cheryl Burke coming in and Chris Jericho. Cool.
Yes.
Chris Jericho, another man.
Well, what's the audition for? Because you're doing the Charlie Sheen thing. That's got some heat.
21 Jump Street.
21 Jump Street.
To be the really lazy gym teacher. whoa, you guys got passes for running around the hallways like idiots? I think I'm going to do my asses like Ronnie B.
Yes.
That's all I got. I'm going to go to the Nike store and get like dolphin shorts and wristbands. You guys got passes for running around the hallways like idiots? It's a cross between Ronnie B and Johnny Depp in Platoon. Important. Maps.
Yeah.
Maps.
It's important.
The tea kettle's still boiling, man. It's cook stuff. Get out of here. No, Sal, this is important. Maps.
Do it for Manny. Sal.
So what did I interrupt?
Nothing.
Before everybody starts complaining that I come in and
fucking
interrupt.
Fucking babble. We were just babbling.
You actually were way better than what we were in the middle of. Yeah. We're doing John Sterling's home run calls.
Yeah.
Do you like that?
No, it is high. It is far. It is gone. A text message from Teixeira.
Why don't they realize it's an embarrassment to
it's
the organization?
It's a late. Sorry, I can't even talk. It's a late night Milky delivery.
Oh, yeah. Right. Yeah.
Milky Cabrera is like, the milkman delivers.
Oh, really?
Benjamin Van Gleason?
Yeah. The milkman delivers. Mr. Faversham, the milkman delivers. The milkman delivers.
If you think that's not a home run, it is out of the question. Out of the question. My friend used to work over there. A friend, a guy I knew that I don't talk to anymore, but in showbiz, it's like a big friend. And he said John Sterling was like oddly and uncomfortably sexually ambiguous.
Really?
So, I understand you're coming down to spring training with us. I'll be at the pool in my Speedo.
Nothing better than the video of him having that grand mal seizure.
Yeah, shake. Grand mal seizure, yeah.
With his weird fist.
And he goes, fist? Oh, he looks like a chimp when he does
that. I think the rest of the world or country realizes how absurd. Like, people here don't realize Vin Scully, like how
great he was.
It is. Like,
still doing
seven out of the nine Astros starters, last name begin with the letter B. And we've got quite a hive here today with Bagwell, Biggio, Bogaerts, Baker,
quite a hive.
He's amazing. Chad Billingsley threw 18 pitches in the first inning, and he's up to his elbows in alligators here in the second. Well, friends, he's just the best.
Effortless, though. And then he's not forcing it.
No. And the Yankees, the biggest franchise in the history of franchise history.
Has a good
redundancy, Department of Redundancy.
Has this.
It'll be a 2-0 to Curtis. Swung, and there goes the deep right. That ball is high. And it is far. It is gone. And the second day. Oh, Curtis, you're something sort of grandish. The Grandy Man can. He hovers in the second deck and right.
Oh my goodness, John!
And the Yankees take a 4-3 lead.
Do you have Susan Waldman?
Susan Waldman!
Goodness gracious! Roger Clemens just said he was coming in George's box!
He's in George's box!
In all my years! And the smile on Jorge Posada!
Of all the dramatic things I've ever seen, goodness gracious! You should see what's going on in the Yankee dugout. Of all the dramatic things I've ever seen, you should see what's going on. Nothing. Goodness gracious.
Nothing was going on.
The first billion-dollar franchise has those two. The Dodgers got Vin Scully. The Cardinals had Jack Buck.
Now they have Joe Buck. Everything I say is exactly the same from start to finish. We hope to have kickoff, and shortly under an hour, there's a fan on the field lighting himself on fire. The Giants have scored 17 consecutive touchdowns, setting a record in the NFL.
Holy shit, you're right.
That's Mark Teixeira's fifth home run of the game. Two grand slams, 14 RBIs on the day. A man has just parachuted onto the pitcher's mound, killing CC Sabathia. Nothing says loving like something from the oven. That's why this game is brought to you by Edmunds Cookies. Manning, still on his feet, throws, caught, Tyree,
the greatest catch in the history of Super Bowls.
Manning, still on his feet, scrambles, throws, Tyree, caught.
Now I got to hear the call.
Oh, shit.
But the
greatest catch ever.
And he didn't pump
fantastic.
It up at all?
He doesn't have...
Goddamn, Jay.
Gregory Peck, I'm not breathing here.
You know we interviewed the guy? Tyree?
Oh, shit.
Tyree?
Did you hear what we did?
No.
Because he did a whole book on the catch, and me and Ann said, we don't want to talk to this idiot. So who was it, E-Rock and Sam? Yeah. E-Rock and Sam played us.
How long ago was this?
Yeah, we
right
did
after,
a franchise.
When he
out of the business now.
Right after, when he had all the heat, we said we didn't take it seriously. We're like, ah, fuck this.
Hey, where's oh, my here it is. Levels?
Levels.
To your right.
To my right.
Travis, help him out.
Third down and 5. Pressure from Thomas off the edge. Eli Manning stays on his feet. Airs it out down the field. It is caught by Tyree.
You're no, Jay's 100% right. The only thing, you get a little confused because he's got to, like, talk louder because of the crowd.
That's
but if you take
caught,
that...
Caught!
Oh, yeah. Fuck you.
He's going to get this out of court! Oh, my God! The goodness gracious!
That's her problem.
Of all the dramatic things I've ever seen...
John, I've never seen David Tyree pin a ball like Bobby Kelly to his helmet.
Helmet.
You gotta be dialing.
Oh, God, that's
great. And she has the horrible Boston accent. So how do you have a horrible Boston accent calling Yankee games? That's sacrilege, too.
I don't get it.
We have a Susan Waldman clip from yesterday. She gives some bold predictions for the 2011 season.
Bold predictions.
Bold predictions.
May I guess? May I guess? How unbold they are, may I guess? CeCe Sabathia, Cy Young, Teixeira, MVP. Mm-hmm. A-Rod's going to have a monster season. Mm-hmm. Albert Pujols, MVP. Mm-hmm. And look out for Clayton Kershaw, John.
John. John, yeah.
And a John Steinbrenner zombie invasion.
It does say,
and Ryan Braun, MVP. That's what
John. Actually, the clip, Jay, you're way off. It's just 2 minutes of her babbling in the pregame.
Was that it?
Just babbling.
Well, the Yankees are now taking the field for the first time in 2011. And it's always a wonderful day here. People are excited. I'm excited. I've been up since 5 o'clock in the morning waiting for this to happen.
Bunch of morons sitting in the rain.
Out to his bleacher creatures. Nick was talking about this in the dinner last night we were all at. He couldn't wait to run out to right field for the first time to greet his bleacher creatures, and they were waiting for him. I think John would agree with me. There is a really good feeling around here.
No, sir.
No, there's not a good feeling.
No, sir.
There's never a good feeling on opening day.
There's a wicked good feeling around here.
No, sir. I just saw Joe Rogan at the Packy store. No, sir.
No, sir.
Oh, fuck yeah. Fucking Paul O'Neill used to rub his fucking cock on the fucking baseline. Who gave a fuck? Louis got that great... I don't know. He probably doesn't do it anymore because he evolves like every year. Like,
he's got a whole nother hour.
He's defying Darwin comedically. But people from Boston, when they hear good news, they act like so pained. Like, oh, good for you, Anthony.
Ah, great. Oh, there we go. Tim McCarver right there on
He can't say Williams. Tim McCarver says Bernie Williams the best.
Williams. Bernie Williams.
You know, that reminds me. Ted Williams was a guy. Williams.
How the fuck do you pick up on that shit?
Holy shit.
It's really
Look
good.
At the guy on the right.
Jay's
just sitting
a
there like
minor
a
bird, man.
Oh, my God.
Holy shit.
I know everyone's talking about all kinds of problems that the Yankees are going to have. There is a very good feeling in this clubhouse. They had a very good spring, despite everything that is supposedly wrong, as Joe Girardi said to me the other day.
What the fuck is she talking
tell me
about?
What
What's
we
wrong?
Can do. Don't tell me what we cannot do. I know what we can't do. I expect, and I think John does too, I expect a mammoth year from Alex Rodriguez. I told him a little while ago, I said, you know,
really?
I'm picking you for the MVP of the league. Don't
I think
disappoint.
They are too.
Huh?
28. I think I'm pretty sure they are too.
Yeah, of course. If you're going to pay the guy 32.
What are the problems that everyone's talking about the Yankees having? You know, Anthony, I've noticed the Yankees not very good drivers. Big problems. Carpal tunnel syndrome from the management people in. I fucking
don't disappoint me. He started laughing. Jeter, do not be surprised if Derek Jeter returns to what. Derek Jeter has been his entire career. I always think that batting average is the least important stat ever been invented.
Hold
just
on.
Show me how
wait,
many
wait.
Right.
What? How often you hit the ball is the least important stat for a hitter? You
in baseball,
fucking dumb twat.
Yeah, for a hitter.
Yeah, tell that to Dave Kingman.
I've always thought
horrible stats.
Oh, Dave fucking Kingman.
Exactly. I'm going way back.
Tommy Lasorda, Dave Kingman. Wait. Dave Kingman.
There's a Tommy Lasorda Dave Kingman clip.
Somebody goes, how'd you feel about Dave Kingman's performance? And he goes, Dave fucking Kingman.
We might have played that one. Do we have it? I got to hear it now.
That is a good one.
Our favorite of all time is the Earl Weaver.
No, nothing's better than... No, that's not your favorite. Listen to me. No, Ope.
Which one is your favorite?
Lee Ilya?
Those are the real Chicago Cub fans. Kiss my fucking ass.
That's a good one.
85% of the fucking world's working. The rest of them are here. It's a fucking playground for the cocksuckers. Those hillbilly motherfuckers ripped those country cocksuckers.
Oh, shit.
I got fucking Garvey and Say, guys that are busting their fucking ass. And those cocksuckers, boo... My fucking ass.
We have played this one. I'm going to challenge you, though, because I think Daryl Weaver is right up there. Let's
Team
start with
Speed, for fuck's sake.
You know.
Oh, he's great.
Nothing's better than Terry Crowley is lucky he's in fucking baseball.
Terry Crowley. Here we go. Lee,
I'll tell you one fucking thing.
Yeah.
Lee,
I
Ilya.
Hope we get Ilya, fucking yeah. hotter than shit just to stuff it up them 3,000 fucking people that show up every fucking day. Because if they're the real Chicago fucking fans, they can kiss my fucking ass right downtown and print it. They're really, really behind you around here. My fucking ass. What the fuck am I supposed to do? Go out there and let my fucking players get destroyed every day and be quiet about it for the fucking nickel dime people that show up? The motherfuckers don't even work. That's why they're out at the fucking game. They ought to go out and get a fucking job and find out what it's like to go out and earn a fucking living. 85% of the fucking world's working. The other 15 come out here. A fucking playground for the cocksuckers. Rip them motherfuckers. Rip them cocksuckers like the fucking players. Got guys busting their fucking ass and them fucking people too. And that's because my fucking ass.
My fucking ass.
They talk about the great fucking support that the players get around here. I haven't seen it this fucking year. The name of the game is hit the ball, catch the ball, and get the fucking job done. Right now, we have more losses than we have wins. The fucking changes that have happened in the Cub organization are multifold. All right, they don't show because we're 5-14. And unfortunately, that's the criteria of them dumb 15 motherfucking percent that come out to day baseball. The other 85% are earning a living. It'll take more than a 5-13 or 5-14 to destroy the makeup of this club. I guarantee you that. There's some fucking pros out there that want to fucking play this game.
Fuck yes.
But you're stuck in a fucking stigma of the fucking Dodgers and the Phillies and the Cardinals and all that cheap shit. All these motherfucking editorials about Say and fucking the Philly-itis and all that shit, that is sickening. It's unbelievable. It really is. It's a disheartening fucking situation we're in right now. 5-14 doesn't negate all that work. Got 143 fucking games left.
That.
What I'm trying to say is don't rip them fucking guys out there. Rip me. If you want to rip somebody, rip my fucking ass.
Lee, you're
but
fired.
Don't rip them fucking guys because they're giving everything they can give. But once we hit that fucking groove, it'll flow. And it will flow. The talent's there. I don't know how to make it any clearer to you. I'm frustrated. I guarantee you I'm frustrated.
Really?
It'd be different if I walked in this room every day at 8:30 and saw a bunch of guys that didn't give a shit. They give a shit, and it's a tough National League East.
Holy fuck, yeah. That is classically
hysterical.
We played
that before.
I never heard a guy say, there's 148 fucking games left.
Yeah, that's what we say.
You go, wow.
Whatever happened to that guy? You know the history?
Fired the next day.
No.
Yes, sir.
Fired the next day.
After only 20 games into the season.
Well, when you tell the fans to kiss your ass downtown and print it.
But he's only telling the fuckers that don't work.
Right.
The ones that show up.
That show up.
Back to Susan Waltman.
Invented. Just show me how many runs you score, how many runs you create for the person in back of you, and I'll show you a winner every time. Robbie Cano, the sky is the limit, obviously, for him. And Mark Teixeira, have had a terrific spring. We'll see how that translates. And we are ready to go. And here we go. And as the first batter, Austin Jackson steps up to the plate.
Oh, gosh.
I hate, this is why I hate the Yankees. It's like she's talking about a fucking somebody's fantasy baseball team that they drafted. Like, you know, CeCe Sabathia, sky's the limit for Robinson Cano, obviously. Picked him up in the third round of my draft. Right. You know, Jeter, don't be surprised if Jeter returns to four. Like, who the fuck is sitting in their fucking Kew Gardens apartment going like, Jeter hit 310? What the fuck? Oh, Jeter, what the fuck? Somebody's been at the Fountain of Youth. Fucking, he had 1 year, he had 260 out of all of them.
Holy shit.
Don't be surprised if fucking Alex Rodriguez has a monster season. Don't let that shock you. What? How the fuck did she get the job?
I don't know.
Do you know how many people, president company, included all of us? The guy's in his room.
Oh, that's funny.
Would you love a job like that?
Yeah, except for the travel part kind of sucks. Like, wait, I got to travel with the team? Yeah. Can't I just simulcast this shit from my house?
Can we play
live from the compound, swinging at a miss?
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not going to Kansas City.
No.
See that fucking double-A squad? They used to be the fucking pride and joy. Remember when we were growing up? Willie Wilson and...
I don't even remember.
George Brett. UL Washington had the toothpick in his mouth. They all had afros and gold chains. It was like the ABA of baseball. Holy shit. Orlando Woolridge was fucking playing.
Shit.
Can we do the Earl Weaver?
Yeah, it's your show. Yeah,
it's opening day.
It's your show. Fuck it.
It's opening day. Let's do the Earl Weaver, too, because it's a challenge. I think this might be better than the one we just heard.
Now, the manager's corner, with the thoughts and opinions of the American League's winningest manager, the Orioles' Earl Weaver. Today's show is sponsored by Baltimore's Six Best, your area Oldsmobile dealer, Anderson Olds, Schaefer and Storminger Olds, Lee Oldsmobile, Metro Olds, City Olds.
How many of those businesses are no longer in business?
And
none
of them.
Everyone
in Baltimore.
Earl Weaver. So Bill Whitehouse, Earl, that certainly is an answer. From Frederick Merrill wants to know why you and the Orioles don't go out and get some more team speed.
Team speed, for Christ's sake. You get fucking goddamn little fleas on the fucking bases, getting picked off, trying to steal, getting thrown out, taking runs away from you. You get them big cocksuckers that can hit the fucking ball out of the ballpark and you can't make any goddamn mistake.
Well, certainly this show is going to go down in history, Earl. Terry Elliott of Washington, D.C. wants to know why you don't use Terry Crowley as a designated hitter all the time.
Well, Terry Crowley's lucky he's in fucking baseball, for Christ's sake. He was released by the Cincinnati Reds. He was released by the fucking goddamn Atlanta Braves. We saw that Terry Crowley could sit on his fucking ass for 8 innings and enjoy watching a baseball game just like any other fan and has the ability to get up there and break one open in the fucking ninth. So if this cocksucker is minding his own business and let me manage the fucking team, we'd be a lot better off.
Well, certainly you've made your opinions known on the fans' questions about baseball, Earl, but let's get to something else. Alice Sweet from Norfolk wants to know the best time to put in a tomato plant.
Alice Sweet ought to be worried about where the fuck her next lady's coming from rather than where her next goddamn tomato plant's coming from. If she'd get her ass out of the fucking bars at night and go hustling around the goddamn street, she might get a prick stuck in her once in a while. I don't understand where these questions are coming from, Tom. That's about it from Manager's Corner. Go fuck yourself and the fuck with your show coming up next on the Baltimore Oriole Baseball fucking network.
Done the outro music.
Yeah, where's the outro music? Fucking Earl Weaver was a classic.
Don't be surprised if Alex Rodriguez has a monster year.
A monster year.
And don't be shocked if Derek Jeter returns to farm. And sky's the limit for Robbie. That's how you know she's a Yankee broadcaster. She calls him Robbie instead of Robinson.
Robbie.
She knows him. Fucking hate the Yankees.
She knows him.
I fucking hate Matt Frost, my stand-up agent, goes, you want to come to the stadium? I said, they tore Yankee Stadium down. What are you talking about?
There's no Yankee Stadium.
And he goes, no, I'm being serious. I go, I'm being serious, too. I would love to go if it was still standing, you fucking dope, going to a mall with a logo on it. Fucking tear down Yankee Stadium.
You got to see the new place just once, though.
Why?
Holy shit. It's just ridiculously awesome.
I'll go to Dodger Stadium. It's been there since fucking 1812. Andrew Jackson chased the Indians out of Florida and put them in Dodger Stadium. That's how long it's been there. It was for Anthony.
History. Yes.
A little history. We should take a break. You're not promoting anything. You're in town doing some shit. Law and Order.
Foxwoods on the 8th.
You are. Oh, fuck. That's next week.
Borgata at the 6th. Yeah, let's just do Foxwoods.
Foxwoods next Friday night? The 8th?
Foxwoods. Yeah.
Fox. In all my years. And let me tell you something. Don't be shocked if Jay Mars is funny that night at Foxwoods on the 8th. He returns to farm. Fucking dolt.
Jay Moore just killed for an hour, and he'll continue with us. I think we got Chris Jericho and Cheryl Burke next as well.
Ooh. Fight! Fight! Wait.
Stay there.
Sirius XM. You're listening to Only Anthony.
Damn, Jay Moore's Jay Moore in the house.
Freestyling.
Jay Moore
freestyling
killed for us.
And shits.
Playing Foxwoods next Friday night.
Way now.
How do they get the
Foxwoods.
Tickets?
Foxwoods.
Foxwoods.com, whatever.
I have no idea.
Foxwoods.
They'll figure it out, and they should go see Jay Moore.
You should come see me because it holds 2,000 and there's 600 tickets sold.
Ah.
Well, so let's pick it up.
Yes.
Well, let's sell some more tickets. Fault.
But we ain't seeing Jay Moore, for fuck's sake.
It's Jay Moore's. Jay I think Moore's. I'm legally changing my name to Jay Moore's. Jay Moore's. So that Moore's. The blacks feel more comfortable when they speak with me.
I like saying Jay Moore's.
Anytime I reference you, I say Jay Moore's.
You should.
I love that Jay Moore's.
You know you my Uncle Anthony. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anthony's going to get everybody pregnant.
Can I say something about Jay Moore? I shot a couple of videos recently, and the one video, Jay's in makeup, you fucking idiots. He's playing a Charlie Sheen character on Law and Order.
A junkie, a half Danish Jew junkie.
I'm going through the comments, and everyone can't wait to hate. They just can't wait to do it. But in the
new single, can't wait to hate.
Can't wait to hate. Can't wait to hate.
And in this case, Jay's made up to look like a cokehead, you dopes.
Yeah.
Jay Moore ain't looking too good.
Is that, yeah.
And hair plugs is the other one, too.
What?
Do you have hair plugs?
Yeah. Can't you see him?
Like, yeah.
My hair plugs when I do a better fucking job. Fucking idiots.
When you just make it really full.
Wouldn't I wear a hat for 2 years like David Spade and then come out the other end looking like Ellen? Yeah, it's the same hairdo.
Yeah, it's the same hairdo.
I figured if I can go bald, I'm 40 now and it's definitely thinner. And I don't care about the yarmulke in the back. I don't give a shit about that.
Because you're tall enough. If you're tall enough, that
you know
it doesn't matter.
It I never thought about
that's
that.
That's exactly what it's all about. If you're tall, at
so
that
if you're
part
like 5'8", it's like, oh, boy.
Oh, fuck, you worry. But if you're like...
No. No, they're looking down at my bones,
the Grandy
bud.
Man can.
The Grandy Man.
Fucking... Let's make a promise with each other. Blood Brothers, like Springsteen, fucking the river style right here.
Yeah.
Let's stay tethered to John Sterling as far out as we go.
Yes.
Let's stay tethered to the Candyman can.
Yeah.
The Yankees win.
It's something sort of grandiose.
What?
What?
A late night milky delivery.
Ew.
Ah. Those eggs smell like Jimmy's here farting.
Ah. I know. Eggs are the worst.
It's just eggs and cheddar.
Are you a fucking wise guy? Are you fucking wise?
Eggs so. Are really bad. Like, I don't know. They just make that
delicious.
Smell.
What's a tattoo, sweetie?
That's something that you won't know. It's just old and it's just, you know.
I'll show you something you don't know.
It's hard to explain. It's not like, oh, it's, you know, some
what's
logo.
What's that say?
I can't see from here.
Yeah, see, you don't know either. So fucking what's up?
I don't know.
God Word. Damn.
Just eating breakfast.
Just eat, eat your halibut, mind your business. Flamingo Kid.
Eat your halibut, mind your business.
Remember the very end of Flamingo Kid?
There they go with the movie references again.
You guys got to follow me. Just quit Twitter and just fucking get off social media entirely. I mean, Anthony can't because that's how he meets every fucking...
Well, you know.
Are you back on Twitter?
I'm on...
No.
I'm
done. I quit Twitter.
But people don't believe
you. Did
you
quit?
Yeah, you quit.
Why
yeah.
would anyone be on Twitter? To
I know.
Fucking sell tickets? It's just a show off. Like, look how funny I was today with my little quip.
It is... mine are just full of arguments. All I do is argue with people and then realize, what am I doing? Why would I do this?
I liked your photos at the Polo Lounge.
Those are cool.
But don't tell Lenore. Don't tell Lenore, because I'm not taking her. Do whatever you got to do. Oh, I will.
No.
Jake, would you stop? You know, take the girls out one last time, training camp.
She did a scene with you or something?
But don't tell Melissa, because I ain't taking her.
Don't tell Melissa.
All right, do what you got to do. Oh, I will.
She said you were very funny.
She was very nice.
Yeah, she did.
But she had a tough gig. You know, you just get made up for like 3 hours because they got to make their hair like
they
4 feet tall.
Bride of Frankenstein hairdo.
And then you just stand there in a photo shoot and they're like, now go sit over there with the fucking...
With James Morris.
No, the bizarre extra table.
The bizarre extra. And she got home that day. I was like, you wrote like... She rode on the fucking subway like that and on the Long Island Railroad with her hair like that. Like, what the fuck?
That's
no doubt. She got a brush?
There's some freaks on the train, though.
Yeah, that's true.
Jesus, I had a dream. I was laying in bed, and I had a dream that I died and God was going over my life. This is after I quit Twitter.
This is profound.
And I realized, first of all, the last tweet I had was, just found out we're doing Suicide Kings 2 in June, all capitals.
Yeah.
The next 40 responses were, I mean, some of them were funny, like, Mannequin 2 thinks this is a terrible idea.
Oh, come on.
Like, that's great. When will you be opening for Paula Poundstone at a steakhouse? Like, who cares?
Wow.
Will you ruin that one also? You suck. You're a fucking piece of shit. So I just retweeted all, like, 20 negative things, and I wrote, this is a fucking crazy place. This is stupid.
Yeah, why?
I don't want you to have a direct line to me.
Yeah.
The only line I want you to have to me is the box office line when you buy a ticket. And I love you. You come see me perform. I'm gonna give you every fucking thing I got.
Yeah.
All of it. And then we'll meet and greet afterwards, and it's a whole thing. But no one. My wife had a good point. She said Twitter should be for people only with SAG cards, and you all start at the same time. Monday at 2:15 in the afternoon Eastern time. Go. Not fuck, you know, you suck. And you're like, what the fuck did I do to you? And then your guy goes, you just fucking suck. Saw you in here after. Nice fucking hair. You're obviously going bald and you have no talent. You're like, no, they made my hair that way to make my character pathetic seed. And then you go, why am I arguing with vet guy 420? When he knows I'm Jay Moore, who lives in Santa Monica, California, and my child's name and my wife's name and my entire IMDb page, and you have a picture of fucking Jesse Ventura from Predator as your picture. why am I arguing with you?
This is fucking perfectly what that is. Perfect description.
My wife said,
holy
the
shit.
Internet is the world's largest bathroom stall. Instead of Twitter, get everyone a fucking Sharpie and a rent-a-car. And you drive up the fucking turnpike, pull over at the Dolly Madison rest stop, and write, you have no hair, you suck, and your wife is a fucking piece of garbage, and then leave, and then another guy comes in to take a shit and goes, hey, fuck you! You fucking suck! And it'll take a lot longer.
That's exactly what it is. I was saying once that Twitter is like when you used to write shit on your desk in school to the guy like, hey, the guy that sits here in third period, you're a faggot.
Van Halen rocks.
No, they don't.
No, they don't.
Yeah,
well,
it was always
you.
Over bands.
Your motherfucker. And that's exactly what this is.
Van Halen's for pussies.
Exactly what this is.
Hey, what you just said, this is like an AA meeting. My last tweet was...
Hi, I'm Jay Moore.
My last tweet was...
I was on jetsinsider.com arguing with this guy. Megalomaniac was his handle.
Okay, great.
That's a good
handle.
He
had a picture of Jimmy Page in his what is it called? Avatar?
Yeah, whatever.
Sig pic and an avatar
fucking
are different.
Yeah, they're about the
dick
same.
Pick.
Avatar is the one next to your name?
And Twitter, right?
Yeah,
we got
a picture of Jimmy Page, and I'm like, we're going back and forth about the Jets, and then I'm like, you don't know what you're talking about? He goes, well, what the fuck do you know? But when you go make Paulie again? And by the way, for the record, everybody, Paulie's a good movie. Like, I stand by Paulie.
Right.
If you have a niece or a net, like, it's not for fucking you idiot 40-year-old Long Island patch hog asshole smoking grass in your mom's bed. Nothing, Ma! And then going out to see Paulie. It wasn't for you. Ma! I gotta smoke this now! I'm going to see Paulie with all my friends. Both of them. So I was arguing with this guy on Jets Insider. I mean, this shit went on for a year.
Oh,
like, my
God.
Post count went up just to tell this guy he was an idiot. Then he changed his avatar photo, and it went from Jimmy Page to a picture of him at his prom.
Oh, shit.
His fucking prom!
Prom.
I was arguing with a fucking 16-year-old. A fucking child is telling me Curtis Martin is a first ballot Hall of Fame. And I'm like going, yeah, maybe not. You know, he's kind of a compiler as a Jet fan. You never once left a Jet game going, fucking Curtis Martin. Can you believe that shit? But you always go, you read in the paper, you go, 120 yards. Like, I didn't even notice. Like,
and you're saying this to a fucking 16-year-old.
But you don't know. I think it's like this cool Jimmy Page guy.
Yeah, Jimmy Page. Why would he? Yeah.
Fucking dolts. And now what's great is Twitter. I changed my password and gave it to Frosty. And so I can't even get on if I want to.
Right.
And then when I see you have like 14 new men, it's still, if I took out my phone and showed you the mentions, like people are still going like, you didn't really quit, did you? Like, hey, I just saw Hereafter. Did somebody dip you in acid? Like, I'm done. I'm out of the fucking game. And it just still,
and it still continues.
Yeah.
People are scumbags.
But when you say, I just saw you in Hereafter, you're saying, I just saw you in a Clint Eastwood movie.
Yeah, yeah.
You suck. So, like, yeah. You can't mesh those two together. I mean, you could if I really sucked in the movie, but I didn't. I thought I was very good. And one review said, underplaying for once. And I agree.
Oh,
I'm learning how to
a little subtlety.
Go under the radar
a little bit.
You don't have to fucking
You're in
show.
A movie with Clint Eastwood. How does anyone spin that?
I can't express to you how little this fucking movie is about you.
That Clint Eastwood story you told?
Love that.
That's one of the best ones.
My problem was never drugs or alcohol. My problem was always P-U-S-S-Y. And then, like, you become so enamored with the guy that you find out he's doing, like, J. Edgar Hoover with Leo DiCaprio, and you're like, I could have played somebody.
Yeah, could you throw
I would have played. I would have laid on my back with my legs in the air for J. Edgar Hoover. Just as,
whatever you need.
So, yeah, Twitter is just I don't need a social network where people that I don't know can directly tell me I suck. And then, conversely, I can't have it, like, be a thing where the only reason I'm on it is so people can directly tell me I'm great. That's disgusting to me also.
Yeah, yeah. You don't want to... Well, you don't just want ass kissers, but the hate that people can conjure up and just the shit. And the fact is, if you're doing something amazing, that's one thing. If you're showing your picture up there and here's what I do, here's my body of work, and you sit there and just go, wow, that guy's fucking talented. It did something, and I guess I am a piece of shit. But like you said, he's fucking, you know, they never show their face. It's always some fucking cool picture they got from
Google Images. It's a picture
of the
ultimate warrior.
Yeah. and they're doing nothing. They have two fucking followers, and I'm going to give them the time of day and then let all of my followers see this guy's comment. No, I send him a private message usually and go, hey, asshole, no one's ever going to see what you wrote. Blocked. And then just block them. And they're gone. They never get the satisfaction of getting their shit out there to everybody that follows me. And I never have to read them again. So fuck them. It's great.
Patrice said that it's like giving your cell phone number out to people so they could beat you up.
So they're not that they're calling you, but it's a
it's
text.
On your phone.
It's a fucking text.
You're like,
people
here,
are texting
here's my,
you.
He goes, here's my cell
here's
phone.
Here's my number. Text me.
Here you go.
Every asshole in the world.
Why would you
here,
do that?
Go ahead. Text me.
Why would
me.
You do that?
Why do you do it?
I don't know.
Why do you do it, Ope? I'll answer for you.
Yeah.
Because you thought going in, we're going to get the fan base going, grassroots, this will help the show.
Absolutely, yeah. A show
And you realize
helper.
With any show, radio or television, any fan site or message board about that show are a bunch of people fucking bitching about their favorite show.
That's it.
Like, holy shit, I fucking love Glee. Let me go on the Glee message board. That show sucked.
You're a bunch of faggots.
Fucking Glee. Why don't they like Kurt Singmore?
Oh, man.
I know everyone on Glee. I'm a Gleek.
Are you a Gleek?
Love Glee.
This just turned into an intervention. Fuck.
Yeah, now I'm feeling like I should...
I just
like
had my last
quit.
Tweet.
I feel like I should quit.
God, I hope it wasn't a fucking sunrise.
What was your last tweet?
I did
your mom's
tweeted.
Box on my last tweet.
You did?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, you did it
it's
right.
Nice to know you're following. Anyway,
hey, wait. I'm going to see what my last tweet
Hold on.
Was.
We got
I had 14 mentions now. I'm not on Twitter,
you're
you
not
fucking
on anymore.
Apes.
Okay, we got to go. We got to get the guys in. We got Chris Jericho and Cheryl Burke down the hall. So get them in here immediately. They only
For
got,
a man
like,
that looks
minutes.
Like he was a chromosome wiggle away from being a family burden, Jay Moore is brilliant. Even the compliments are mean.
The compliments suck.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I don't know what that's about. Because they claim to be fans of the show, and it doesn't seem that way.
Hey, yeah.
What are they doing? Dance with the Stars, right? Chris Jericho.
Chris Jericho's coming in. He's doing that Dancing with the Stars. That's a strange show, you know? You dance the foxtrot. I can't tell if he's behind me or not. So I can turn my head like this.
He's a badass. Chris Jericho's a badass.
We'll see.
That right, is the yeah, best like fucking that. Norm, man.
Jay Moore, Calves of an Angel.
Ah,
that's
see?
From Opie's thing.
There you go.
Opie, fill me in my underwear.
Ah, there he is. Look at that dapper you're looking, man. God damn you.
You're looking more and more Hollywood.
You look Hollywood.
I got damn sweats on today.
Jesus Christ. Look at you, man.
We've known both you guys for a very long time. Cheryl Burke. I don't know why we're not giving the attention to the beautiful girl.
Hi, Cheryl.
Beautiful girl.
We are. Chris Jericho.
Where were we last night, Cheryl? Kit Kat Club? Did you guys go out last night?
No, man.
Why not? You got to just keep dancing.
Kit Kat Club?
We rehearsed until like midnight, and then we came over here. So I have to be responsible now during the course of this show.
This is like a lot of work, real work, right?
It's a lot of work, more than you ever expect when you first sign up for it. I mean, it literally is like 6 or 7 hours a day, every day, and you need that time to be somewhat decent if you're going to be somewhat decent.
What dance are you guys working on?
This week we're doing the rumba.
The rumba.
The rumba.
The forbidden dance.
Last week we did the quick step, and the week before that we did the cha-cha.
Yeah.
Would you ever thought that Jericho would be doing the cha-cha?
I did.
You did? You thought about it for years, right?
Yeah, when I see you, you got the moves of an angel, man. You're very dexterous and
ambidextrous.
I
can move both ways.
Yeah, I said fucked up and went, oops.
Yeah. Now that's serious.
Did the wrestling career help you with this for choreographing moves and remembering what you're supposed to do?
I haven't wrestled since high school, Anthony. But
Jim Moore, I was talking to me.
I thought, okay, because the comedy helped me. It's interesting because there's a lot of stuff that you do in wrestling that you can actually transpose into dancing. Balance.
When you suplex your partner.
Weight distribution.
Greatest thing.
She's actually a firecracker.
Yeah.
She's a taskmaster. So aren't you, Cheryl?
Yeah, I'm just moody.
Are you really? Yeah. Do you tell him what the hell you do? Come on, knock it off.
Yeah.
Why are you moody?
Be good.
She has a reputation of being like the master, the taskmaster of the show because she's very blunt. And you know, in Hollywood, as you know, Jay, everyone tells you what you want to hear. They're always kind of stroking.
Unless it's Twitter. Stroking
that's why I come ego. In here.
Not, yeah,
tell me I'm an idiot. This call bad.
This cuts you right back down to size coming on this show. But Cheryl's not like that. She tells you what you need to hear to get better because you don't have a lot of time to do the different routines and stuff like that. So balance, weight distribution, choreography, live performance, all that stuff is kind of wearing spandex and rhinestones. I mean, that's exactly what I've been doing for 20 years. Exactly.
Who's gotten kicked off? Because I don't really.
I
watch
my
a little
boy
bit.
Mike.
From Kevin and Bean. We were just talking
about. And from
about.
Loveline. Yeah, he's one of Drew's guys.
He was their Jimmy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And he made it to Dance with the Stars.
Yeah. Yeah, he was actually a really funny
guy.
He's
a great kid, man.
He actually hosted Regis, too. He might be the new Regis.
Does Wendy Williams look like a monster in person?
She's a big lady.
Shit. It's like being in the post with Kurt Thomas. She's a fucking power forward if I've ever seen one.
Yeah, holy she's a big lady.
She just
lady.
Has to be... If you shrink her down, then I think she might be hot. But she's way too fucking large.
But she's purple.
She's big. Yeah, she's big. But
she's an odd shade. I mean that as pragmatically as possible.
Of course.
You're being polite.
Like when Al Roker lost all the weight, he turned gray.
Yeah, he did.
Like she's that weird.
She's got a strange hue to her.
She does have a strange, maybe hue is the better word in these politically correct times.
Strange, yes, exactly.
Well, my fucking show's canceled, what do I care? She's a fucking strange looking black lady.
Okay.
Black man. Which one is she?
Cheryl wants out already.
Wendy Williams is such a strange looking black person, Kim Kardashian just fucked her.
I don't even know if that makes sense.
Well, because you know,
it kind of does.
She's kind of manly.
Chris Humphries from the Nets.
I get it.
I know you get it, but I gotta.
She has a type.
You gotta explain for the listeners sometimes.
She has a type.
Yeah.
Yes,
Cheryl. I apologize for my potty mouth.
How many seasons have you done this Dance with the Stars?
That's my 11th season.
Wow. 11.
Damn. Girl, you paid.
Who'd you have in the past?
Drew Lachey, my first season. Emmett
he won,
Smith.
Didn't he?
Yeah.
She's won twice. She's a two-time champion.
Oh boy, not a three-time though.
You won with Emmett.
But thanks for the thumbs up on that.
Not a three-time.
No man.
Emmett Smith.
Jeez.
All 11
Emmett
of my
Smith.
Votes are going to Jericho.
Ocho nice. Cinco.
Yes.
You had Ocho.
Rick Fox. She gets all the athletes.
Wait, wasn't there a rumor of you and Ocho?
Not at all.
It was out there, though.
That was quick.
No,
she tried. That was a little
she
too
wants
rumor.
Out of that. She wants out of that
thou
rumor.
Thou doth protest
rumor.
Too much.
She did not happen.
He was playing it. See, I know a little bit about the show. He was working a lot.
Girls.
Who, Cheryl gets the athletes all the time.
Were you ever romantically linked to any of your dancers?
I mean, honest.
This is no one
Wayne
listens.
Newton.
Nobody cares.
Wayne Newton and I, you know.
Tom DeLay has a horse cock.
Apparently.
It's funny because it's true.
That's the jargo we remember.
Yeah, oh, do I never went anywhere. Just because I'm a dancer now doesn't mean that I don't...
You're not even a dancer yet.
Oh, yeah, see, there you go.
Oh,
now you're starting
to...
No,
she did. Yo, you Jordans are
now
fucked
up. Now you're bringing up.
J-Mores, you my uncle. I'm going to get Chris Jericho pregnant. Tracy
you sound
Morgan
like Tracy Morgan there.
Well,
yeah,
I hope so.
Yeah,
that's why they call it an impression, Chris Jericho.
It took me a couple minutes to get hip to that one.
I'm going
to
get Tom Bergeron pregnant. Make Bergeron babies. Yeah.
Babies.
Holy shit. Who do you think on the show this season has a chance that you're like looking at going, uh-oh?
Other seasons have had like ringers in the past, like one of the Pussycat Dolls did it, and Osmond did it. Those damn Osmonds.
Yeah,
been dancing since they
talented.
Were embryos. Always yes. Freaking dancing. Last year was the chick from Dirty Dancing, you know. So, but this year we don't have
and her new face.
Anybody like that. Yeah, exactly.
She doesn't even look like
exactly.
her anymore.
Everything was dancing but her face. It was frozen in position.
For her. You know what I say? God bless.
Yes, go for it, right? Yeah, you're talking about working it. I think she's like 60 or something, so she looked great. But for this season, there's really like it's kind of a wide playing field.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of people that are doing good, but no one's really had any previous dance experience. So.
What about Ralph Macchio?
Ralph is actually pretty good.
Is he good?
He keeps working this gimmick where he's like, oh, I'm so old and I'm hurt and my body hurts. And he gets out on the dance floor and just fucking kills it. So I think he's working a little bit of a wrestling gimmick where he's trying to shark you, like a pool shark.
Play
I don't know how to play
bit.
Pool. And then he gets all
he looks like a dancer. Let's
he's got progeria.
He's got 70 years old, Norm MacDonald, and Dancing with the Stars, Ralph Macchio, has progeria. He was in that Karate Kid, you know? In 1941, they showed it to the troops. Now, are we talking about the Rifleman? Chuck Connors. God damn it.
You've got the Norm MacDonald smile.
Like an idiot staring at the sun, yeah? That's amazing. Chris Jericho has a successful career as a WWE superstar. And now he's dancing. But at least you got the beautiful Cheryl Burke there, huh? She's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful gal. But I wouldn't mind dancing with at all.
That's great. That's God the most damn. We've heard of Norm MacDonald in years.
He was on 2 days ago.
There you go. I didn't listen 2 days ago.
Cheryl, what partner have you had? Dancing, excuse me. Let me make that more specific. Yes, what dancing partner have you had? And maybe you have a confidentiality agreement and you can't say, was like pretty difficult personally. Like what's wrong with this person? Why can't they just do what I say and we could win if this person would just leave?
Chris.
No, you too.
He keeps trying to insult me.
These two.
I think the actors that I've been with, I think because of their insecurities.
Names, please.
I can't.
Show me.
I can't name specific names. Show
me.
If Sam Googles who her partner's on, instead of standing there
with
a stupid smile on his face.
With that fucking bunch of asparagus for hair.
Exactly. His Kramer's just getting out of control now.
I like how
he wears it back with like a beret.
Yeah, what the fuck?
When have we seen a beret since 1965?
You look like you're in the produce section of fucking Whole Foods, you idiot. Put the fucking camera down and look it up, stupid.
See, the thing is, a lot of people... A lot of people think when you do this show that you're instantly going to be a ballroom dancer. And it takes 20 years to be like, if I said, okay, you're going to learn how to wrestle opening in two weeks. And,
no.
You know, it takes years and years and years and years, you know, stand-up comedy, anything.
10,000 hours.
Maybe 12,000.
75
hours of learning you need. So you can't just waltz in, no pun intended, and become a ballroom dancer. Some people think they can do that. It's impossible. You have to realize that this show is not built on the dancing, per se. It's built on the show business aspect. The personality, the character, the charisma, all that sort of stuff.
Gives you more exposure.
Let me tell you something.
You do learn quickly.
You don't care if you learn how to dance, let's be honest.
You have to do the best you can.
Not for the celebrities.
It's great exposure.
You have to do the best
you
can.
They have a reason why
they're doing. Are you guys middle of the pack?
We tied for first last week. So
that's not middle of the pack. What actor? I still want to know what actor.
Well, E-Rock's got the list.
E-Rock's on it?
Yeah, her first partner, Drew Lachey.
Lachey.
Drew Lachey's on there. He was a good one.
Look at the game tape.
Yeah, you got it. Right.
Oh, E-Rock.
He did not just do that.
It'll get better E-Rock, as it goes
how
on.
How could you get Lachey from Nick Lachey? It's an easy transition.
God damn it.
Then you have Emmett Smith.
Emmett Smith.
Tell me who
Smith.
You want, and I'll just spin the wheel.
Ian Ziering.
Uh-oh.
It's actually Ian
And he
Ziering.
Thinks he's hot shit because he married like a penthouse from the 80s. Like, wow, here's my fucking prime pussy. I'm ready to fucking treat everyone like an asshole. Look what I got at home. Hey, Ian, look what I got at home. Right. Suck my balls.
Have you ever met anyone
fucking blonde Jew Frodo? Name...
A-I-N, that's Ian.
Ian, okay.
Ian.
Not Cheryl, Ian, Ian.
Was Ian a pain Ian. In the ass?
No.
I'm gonna wear you down.
You can't.
Jay
do that.
Will wear you down.
I'm not talking about words.
You can't. I can't get fired from my show.
You can't get fired from saying who was a jerk.
Really?
No, I just said who was a little very difficult to work with.
I said mainly all the actors I've been with.
So Ian Ziering was difficult
for the
to work,
reason that they think they can be ballroom dancers
because,
easily, right?
You know,
yeah, I'm your
actors.
Ballroom dancer, dancer for money.
That one was okay. I like the other. What was the one before
Fuck
that? Michael Madsen?
No, that was a good one, Chris.
Oh, shit.
That was
kind of tell.
He's
but you were in the right
ones.
Movie.
He's got a lot of good ones.
Yeah, it does. No one does
Chris
Tina
Jericho
Turner.
Turned it into a goddamn shooting gallery.
Harvey Keitel?
Bam!
Keitel.
Bam! Yes. If we could just get Cheryl Burke to tell us what we need to know. Who was difficult to work with? Then we will know. Ian Ziering? Bam! Turned into a goddamn shooting gallery. What the fuck was Joe thinking? To hire an animal like that.
Can you do Opie or Anthony?
Holy shit.
All right. All right.
No, we want to get something out of this
interview. Ian Ziering.
We want to talk about the Fox Trot.
Something out of this
we
interview.
We want to talk about the Foxtrot.
By the way, completely misnamed... dance. You think it's gonna be like hot and like jumping around. The foxtrot's like super slow and deliberate and like plodding almost, right?
Yeah. The
dance talk.
Yeah.
Well, that's easy, but whoever knows any of these dances, like you show up there and it's like this week you're gonna be doing the rumba. It's like, well, what the fuck one is that? Like, we don't know. I've never heard of any of these things before.
Why are you
cursing? Well, I'm trying to keep up with you.
Do it on your friends.
I do one imitation.
I do one imitation.
Yeah.
I'll do my Lars Ulrich imitation. So I fucking went on to the Sirius radio with Opie and fucking Anthony. I was sitting right next to Jay Mohr. He was so fucking crazy. It was the funniest thing I've ever heard in my life. That's my one impression.
He was in Get Into the Greek, wasn't he?
He was.
Lars.
Who's on the phone, babe?
Who's on the phone, babe? Get Russell Brand out of here. He's got a big fucking cock.
Who else?
I love that.
That's
impression.
All I can do.
That's all you need is one good one.
You get one. That's it.
That's fine.
I got my one.
Then you have Cheryl. Wayne Newton.
All right. Well, we know Wayne. Newton. By my wife
Wayne
said
Wayne Newton is the nicest guy in the world.
My wife said Wayne Newton not only the nicest
that's
guy in the world,
you're hot.
The greatest smelling man in the world.
He smells like,
did he smell good?
Smells really? Like heaven and the inside of a Porsche.
He was a guest star.
He was a guest star in Las Vegas.
Why does he smell good?
Fucking Wayne
just
Newton.
Good cologne.
Who the fuck are you?
The best cologne.
To ask that
in Vegas. Well, I mean, is it in?
He hasn't spent his entire career rolling
inside?
Around with other men.
It's
the it kind of rubbed off.
Watch it. Watch it.
Oh shit! That's
I can't
right.
turn my head.
Jay was a wrestler back in the day.
Watch it.
Jay's got a fucked up neck there.
Did anyone ever pull that finger move on you where they jam their finger in the guy's asshole? I heard about that.
Only until
move.
I came. That's good. You get a front headlock on a kid, you roll them, and your coach is like, legs, legs. And you're like, not yet.
What was the bit that you did where you were banging a chick and you pulled out and left the state of Hawaii? That's like your famous.
Line.
That's your
wow,
rock and roll
Jericho.
Night.
That's a classic.
That's his,
yes.
that's
his, show.
That's
show.
That's his
show.
Walk this way of that, comedy.
That,
yes.
that made it on a t-shirt.
Map of Hawaii.
I made it on a t-shirt. That's his walk this way. That's his biggest hit.
You know, I go, I'll do shows and people go, do walking. I'm like, have you ever seen the fucking Eagles in concert? Do you sit there and yell Hotel California the second you hit your chair, idiot? It comes at the end.
Don't so people do yell for it.
Give
them
time.
They want to hear that
but
one.
Now they yell for Tracy, too.
Yeah. Oh,
okay. And then they're going to start yelling for Cheryl. Cheryl and I are going to actually, we should announce it. We're touring together.
Yes.
We're my torpedo of truth. Charlie Sheen. Duh, winning. We're talking about an Oscar, man. I won one when I was 20. I wasn't even warm. Where does Charlie Sheen keep his imaginary Oscar? And his unicorns
ass. Fuck, he didn't win an Oscar, you fucking asshole.
Is he coming to town?
It's a mad
Radio City. Are you guys going?
You have to.
We might, just to check it out.
I'm going. I mean, what's he gonna do? What's he gonna do?
3,000 seats not sold.
He said he's gonna rip.
Really?
They sold out, but it was all ticket brokers.
Ticket brokers, they had a big ticket broke.
They can't get rid of these things.
He's gonna riff.
Yeah. He's just gonna riff on.
Jim, I was watching Bill Maher had on.
He's gonna riff.
What's Belzer? And they were talking about, and the guests were like, "I think it'll be great." And they go, "Yeah, for about 9 minutes." And then Belzer goes, "Then it's gonna be a slow, anxious crawl to 9:30, babe." Fuck it. He's gonna be like, "Who wants to see Brie Olsen's tits again?" When I was a kid, goddesses were way hotter in my mind. I didn't think you pulled a couple sixes out of the San Fernando Valley, Bob's Classy Lady. And a goddess to me, like Cheryl, is a she's a beautiful
Bob's Classy Lady.
It is. Like Cheryl, seriously, like a gorgeous girl. She's in phenomenal shape. You see her in the news. They always get pictures of you. Like, and you got to stay out of Maui. That's where the paparazzi is. Yeah. Unless you go because you want your picture taken.
No,
because you got that hot rockin' bod in the bikini in Maui. Happily married babe. Don't read into it.
You throw a little babe in there.
B-Rock. Who else?
Then you have Christian De La Fuente.
I don't know what the fuck that is.
No, is he the guy that showed his cock in Sex and the City?
No.
I can't believe he was available.
No clue.
No. he's some Latin soapstar.
Oh, he's a Latin
soapstar?
Fucking
Jay, man.
Okay. Who else?
Maurice Greene.
Athlete.
He's the runner.
He's the runner.
Yeah.
The
athletes.
Yeah.
That's Cheryl's
like
4K.
The athletes.
Giles Marini.
Gilles Marini.
Oh, my God. French you guy. Are butchering but, all the... It's fantastic.
We don't know that guy either.
Who is Gilles?
But I'm not reading it.
Yeah, true.
He's the guy that showed his cock in Sex and City.
Oh. Okay.
That's what he's known for. They actually hired his cock.
Trivia with Chris Jericho.
They hired his cock to dance. Gilles Marini's cock was actually the one that was listed to dance.
Now, Cheryl, when you date outside of the show, obviously, because...
She's suffering. Look at her.
I don't want to make you uncomfortable.
You're suffering.
Believe me.
You have a bit of jungle fever, correct?
No.
Don't lie.
Oh, damn.
Sometimes.
Sometimes is all the time if you're a white person.
That's true. We look at that as all the time.
Really?
Yeah. What is this, 1987?
Yeah. To Anthony?
Jungle fever?
No, I'm just speaking for Anthony.
Yes. People like...
Jungle fever.
Jungle.
We like going old school sometimes.
My wife said to me once, "Aren't you glad I never slept with a black guy?" Case. Oh, I gotta realize this all has traction, and fucking 6 years from now, I'll be applying for a Tyler Perry movie, and they'll pull this fucking quote up.
I never said this one.
Nope.
Tyler Perry.
We like this Jay Moore kid. Has he ever said anything?
So Ian Ziering was a pain in the neck. You can nod or shake your head, and I will not out what your. Who knows?
Something. Okay.
Who knows?
She doesn't want to get in trouble.
So when the show is on, the show is called Dancing with the Stars. I understand.
When do you guys dance next? Monday.
Every Monday.
So what? All weekend.
So that's the thing. No,
you're not going to practice all week.
Every day, man. You got five days.
A fucking man.
You have 5 days to do this.
To figure it all out.
Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. You're already in the studio doing rehearsals and stuff. So this schedule's nuts, man. Because this training is some of the hardest training that I've ever done. And you guys know all the stuff that I've done over the years. Mm-hmm. But this is fucking crazy because it's like aerobics and yoga combined. Like there's so much stuff you don't even realize when you're learning to do this when you watch it on TV because they make it look so easy as far as positioning and frame and toes down, heels up, shoulders down, elbows up, chin up, and it's all the like it's too much to remember. So you really have to spend 7-8 hours a day to do this. That's
How much weight have you lost so far?
Probably about 10 pounds or so.
You know? Now, is being gay, has that helped you learn?
Yeah, I mean, naturally. Of course. You get in touch with your feminine side, and you can work with that. You know, you got a little more flair, a little bit more pomp and circumstance. I'm a real bitch in the morning, though.
Yeah.
So that doesn't help much.
I do miss that little fountain on top of your head.
Like that one, huh?
That little, what did we used to call when,
I'm
when
not
Chris,
saying it.
When Chris
oh, wait,
went
I'm
out,
not done. Saying it.
You know what we used to wear that ponytail
say
right on top
it.
Of his head. And we would call it the jizz fountain.
Yeah. I like how suddenly Opie had some morals. And some
know, right?
some remorse. I'm not saying that.
I'm done with
it
that.
It was funny.
It was 10 years ago.
Oh, yeah. It was funny.
Yeah, it was funny.
It's back when we didn't know
Sam. We called you Pebbles and stuff. Right?
Yeah, well, now Pebbles Flintstone.
And hey, hello, that's why I had it. So that people like you would insult me for it, you idiots.
Exactly. He was a heel.
By the way,
he was
a bad guy.
Having the camera just on a close up of Cheryl's face, not making her uncomfortable at all. Fucking stalking lunatic.
Oh, believe me, no, we know.
Don't sell to TMZ.
It's always on me. Believe me.
Believe me, we know Sam. It's always on the fucking wrestler.
He's a stalker for the WWE guys. Even though Chris isn't wrestling.
No
WrestleMania for you this year.
Triple H was fucking creeped out by him yesterday? Day before?
2 days ago.
It's his eyebrows.
Ago,
look at those things.
He's creeped out. He's just like, you're everywhere. He goes, I see you everywhere. And when a wrestler notices some guy has been everywhere, that's fucking scary.
He's got a couple Hitler mustaches above his eyes. It's freaking me out.
Look at those things.
Spee-wee would be freaked out.
That is fucked up.
Cheryl, as a star of Dancing with the Stars, where did you grow up?
I grew up in San Francisco.
Born and bred?
Yes.
And that's where you began. You obviously began dancing at what, 5, 6?
4.
4 years old? Oh, what a cutie pie. I miss my daughter. I would love to have a daughter and take her to little dance classes. What's cuter than that? Instead, you got a boy, you take him to the beach, he gets dog shit on him somehow. Like, how the fuck do you leave this fucking Pacific Ocean with dog shit on you? Yeah. Just lucky, I guess. Fuck, they're so stupid. Boys are dumb.
She had a big time story. I don't know what your... Do you talk about that shit anymore? It was in your book.
Story?
The mailman.
What?
Yes, no, of course I talk about it because it's in my book.
Was he black?
Absolutely. No.
She was 6.
No. Had a girl.
She was 6, and there was a retired mailman that might have.
Oh my God!
Done a thing or two.
What?
But she's not a victim, which I respect.
Guys are disgusting.
I'm not trying.
She talks about it, man.
I do talk about it.
The only reason I bring it up because it was in your book. But yes. The thing I wanted.
Mailman delivers.
The thing I wanted to bring up was that the guy got released recently, right?
Yeah, he is released.
He did 20. He did 20 years. And now he's out.
He's out.
Wow.
Who's looking for him?
You want Billy Hayes to go talk to him?
Billy Hayes will talk to him.
Where is he?
He's actually stationed, I think, close to where I was.
Stationed?
What do you mean stationed?
Like, he's been taken care of because he's about to die.
Oh, so like he's in an old folks home or something?
Old folks home, yeah.
Oh, so they have him in an old folks home.
You should get 20 years from what happened with you only? Or is it a cumulative?
Yeah. Good.
You should whisper some shit in his ear that makes him die, like fucking some gladiator shit.
Like a spell?
At the baby inside of me. It's not of your... The king's fucking just dying there. You should do that. What are you talking about? It's Gladiator.
It's Gladiator. Come on, Chris.
Jay's just like, don't ask him. He'll just keep going.
Yeah, just go with it over and over again.
What I like about Cheryl, though, is
she's not a
people
victim.
in this country, I don't know about the rest of the world, you have to learn how to turn the fucking page and not be defined by shit that happened to you. We all got fucking... had an uncle or a cousin or older kids in the woods, and then you did it to the kids younger than you.
Not me, but
other kids like me in New Jersey.
Ah, you've overcome.
But turn the fucking page. Don't let it define you. And on here you have you are the biggest star dancer on the show, like except for that one that looks like Mickey Rooney, that fucking blonde guy.
Derek.
Holy shit. When is he making his next movie with Judy Garland?
Say, gang, why don't we all get together and do a nice dance?
We'll put on a show, see? That'd be a good idea.
And didn't he hook up with... So but you are the biggest star on that show.
She is. She is.
Distant second is that little chimpish
Hobbit.
Girl.
Oh, the chimpish girl.
Mario Lopez girl.
Karina.
Karina Karas. Smirnoff. Yeah, she's like half
she
Gibbon.
Wait, is there... Oh, my God.
Half Gibbon.
Cheryl's the real star of the show.
No, is
you
the,
know why? Because she rocks the bangs. It's hard to dance with bangs. She pulls it off every week.
That's pretty cool.
Is the Russian girl still dancing? Jeffrey Ross's old partner? I forgot her name. She had
Edita. No, she's Polish. She's not dancing anymore.
Why? What happened? Pulled a hammy?
Jeffrey Ross.
I don't know.
Jeffrey Ross ruined her?
Yeah, probably.
Jeffrey roasted her.
She used to be right to look at.
Let me ask you guys a quick question as comedy geniuses.
Ah, yes.
All three of you.
Of course.
Why would they even ask Situation to do... The Trump roast. Why would they even ask him?
Because it's a big name now, and it's popular just it culture. And who cares if he's funny or not? Just throw him on.
But is he in any relation to Trump at all?
No.
No.
Okay, because that was one of the most painful things I've ever seen.
But most of those people don't have a relationship with...
Yeah. All right. Come on now. Like, that was going to fucking work when his jokes didn't go over. It was kind of a sea... It's funny you bring that up. It's kind of a sea... I've been thinking about this. It was a bit of a sea change... for American audiences, for
they weren't saying, we don't think what you're saying is not funny.
Right.
But through his unfunniness, they began to heckle because they realized, what the fuck are you doing here?
Exactly. Yes. Exactly. Who is
That's
this guy?
That's where the heckles came from.
Exactly.
Because his jokes.
Exactly.
Like, if I said him or you
they
said
wouldn't
him,
have been bad.
They would have
right.
worked.
They would have worked. You're right.
Yeah.
The but then when he hit Jelesnik or whatever that guy is, you go, but it was like, you could tell that's the one he wrote. Mm-hmm. He goes, yeah, that's nice. But I was at my house fucking a model on a bag of money.
Yeah, in my, in like, my yeah. mansion.
In my yeah. mansion.
Really?
You're like, well, obviously that's
and
the one
was
you
laughing.
Wrote.
Yeah.
And it was the fifth one this week.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, it was that uncomfortable silence where people were saying, what the fuck is this guy even doing up here?
It's a tough hustle, roast. I got booed off stage at the Drew Carey roast.
Yeah, but did you?
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I had to go.
Why?
I said, Mayor Dinkins and Mayor Abe Beam are here. They're going to go out back after the show and have a bad mayor off. And I got booed.
Come on, that's funny.
And Freddie Roman goes, wait, you're out of line. I go, really? There's a
out
dead
of roast? You're out of line?
I go, there's a dead Hasid in Crown Heights that agrees with me.
Yeah.
Because all the Jews and blacks were fighting.
Sure, how yeah. is that out of line?
Because nothing's they're out of line at a friars. Roast. And Freddie Roman had a couple pops. And I go, are you talking to me or that fucking rabbit on your head? And they're like, and the crowd was like, yo, whoa now.
You can't do that to See, Freddy. It's funny, but it's over the line funny, maybe. But,
the situation one was past that.
I'm not
beyond,
a big fan
beyond,
of roast, because no one's
like
roast.
That.
They don't roast the ones they love. They roast the ones that are fucking
Easy
low
victims.
Enough on the totem pole that they'll agree to be on a roast.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You never see like fucking John days. Cryer sitting there. You know why? Because he's making 1.5 an episode.
Why would he do that, right?
Yeah.
We got to get these guys out. They got to go
oh
to Fox.
Oh, my God. I'm trying
gonna
already?
They're going to waltz on out
Remember
of here.
Oh, that's a go.
Cheryl, do you have a favorite seat? Obviously, the seasons you win are probably the ones that stand out, but they may not necessarily be your favorite seasons, correct? Are there seasons that you didn't win that was just
yeah.
so much damn fun?
I had fun with Gilles Marini. The guy that showed us
the cock,
penis.
The cock guy,
Kyle Mary.
I'm trying
Gillis
to put this
Mern.
On track. For,
yeah, we had fun.
Did he let you see it?
No.
Showed it once.
Oh, Jesus.
No,
show it once. Show it
to
the
world.
Right, you pick up a bonus when you win. You pick up a bonus.
We just continue to get paid throughout the whole season.
The more episodes they last,
but
the more money
win,
they make.
Oh, I got you.
There's got to be a little cheddar at the
yeah,
end.
If you win, nothing.
Endorsements. Endorsements.
Great. Yeah, endorsements.
She's got a lot of endorsements.
What do you do for, like, shampoo and stuff?
Jazzercise is one of them.
Jazzercise.
Full Fast is a diet spray.
Love Full
Fast. Right. Did the whitening strips before?
For the hair?
Crest.
Crest is
yes,
good.
Crest's a big
I did,
one.
Big Sexy Hair.
She's got a lot of them. She's got dance studios. See, she's smart. She's branding herself.
Yeah.
She's going out there in the world and making her fame and fortune.
Mickey Rooney impersonator like the other one.
It's Mickey Rooney.
Is there a dancer?
Oh, we don't come on, fucking Roland. We get it. They got to go.
We understand. Fuck off.
Look.
Jeez.
Where do you guys have to go next?
Fox.
We are Fox, TV. We're coming back here. We're everywhere.
I hear
you. You got to pull them out of here, Roland.
All right. Get them the hell out of here, then,
You get the hell out of here.
Now you get the hell out of here.
You're fired here.
Chris Jericho, get your ass out of here. I don't want to see you again, Twinkle Toes. Now get out.
Sure, I'll call you later.
See, I set you up there.
I love that. I like it.
Thing going on here.
Continued success.
I don't think
thank you
guys.
He doesn't miss Vince right now, I bet.
Are you guys going
to... Let really me ask Anthony,
are you going to vote for me on Monday?
Of course. It's all about Chris Jericho.
See, even though you can vote 11 times.
Take it easy.
Nice to meet you, man.
Let me get a little
All right, Chris.
There.
We'll all vote for you. Let's get the audience to vote for Chris.
Going to do that when I leave, too?
She's a firecracker.
Yeah, we'll check out your ass, Chris.
She's got legs like Earl Campbell.
Jesus.
I turned around and I went, that's not what I was expecting at all.
I'm going to use my Lars Ulrich. You feel free to use it.
All right.
I'm going to call
it's
you.
It's yours.
Chris, thank you.
Yo, Horace Grant, call me.
Thanks, Chris.
Chris Jericho.
Later, man. Chris is
fucking,
looking so Hollywood,
fight,
man.
When she got up, I'm like, is that Joe Morris from the Giants? The fuck happened?
Tiny little Joe Morris.
She's, from the belly button up, you go, oh, it's a
that's
cute
right,
kid.
She's
right?
tiny.
And then
she's
when she leaves, girl. You go, whoa, some good. Squat thrust.
She probably supplements with the heels. She wears those heels.
Can I acknowledge that was the best Lars I've ever heard in my life?
That was Lars Jericho.
I heard he's already getting divorced from his girlfriend, Kelsey Grammer.
Oh, really? From his girlfriend?
No.
That other one?
That's what I'm just telling you what I heard.
Wow.
I'm only joking.
Oh, April Fool's.
Yeah.
Braveheart, Aunt. Braveheart.
Braveheart.
They can't go on with their lives. What? You said Gladiator.
Oh, it was Braveheart.
Braveheart. All right.
Go fuck your mother.
Why don't we take a break? More with Jay Moore. Jay Moore, Foxwoods, week from today.
4-8. Wait, no. What's April? 4?
Can I go?
Yeah. No.
I can't go.
Only if you bring my main man.
Who that? He likes my son.
That's my homie right there.
We don't talk about my son.
Who that?
No? Because Ant doesn't like kids.
What? No, I like kids. They're funny. I like that crying kid that wants to be the fucking governor of Jersey.
Your girlfriend told me you don't want kids to get germs on your couch.
No, I hate that.
Boogers.
Specifically.
Booger couch.
She goes, fucking germs on the couch. Yeah. I'm like, all right, we just met. I go, how are you? She goes, good. I'm Melissa. I go, yeah. So you're, yeah. She goes, yeah, fucking germs on the couch. Apropos of nothing. She just fucking launched into
I just
it.
Launched into right a tirade there. Of fucking germs
you know
on the
what?
Couch.
I fucking got off track because I wanted to have some I just wanted her to stay in her chair because I tried to make it look like an interview, but I wanted to really get into fucking Keitel and Burke.
Oh,
smoking
yeah.
Grass.
Beautiful girls.
Kit Kat. I said Kit Kat.
Kit Kat Club. Love that.
That's okay.
I watch that movie now and I can't. It's Jay Moore doing that
fucking.
It's an
incredible movie.
But it's Jay Moore doing the part now. I can't watch that. I can't watch Keitel anymore doing anything. Thank you, Jay.
What kind of businessman are you? You can't back your own product.
More with Jay Moore. Foxwoods next Friday.
Yes.
Figure out how to get your own tickets because Jay Moore's not on Twitter to tell you. Or no. You should have...
Go to fucking Foxwoods and buy tickets.
Yeah, it's easy.
Let's do that.
Is that your...
Yeah, that's her. She's laying down there.
We'll be back.
Boudoir. Yeah.
The virus. Call the Opie and Anthony Show now. 866-WOW-1-WOW. That's 866-969-1969. Send your feedback to feedback@opieandanthony.com. The Opie and Anthony Show.